What's up, guys? It's your favorite twins, and today we're revisiting Ariana Grande's second studio album, My Everything. This is one of the biggest albums in her discography, and we've hit just about everything.
Just about everything. It's just this one, and then Yours Truly.
No, to be honest with you, when I think about My Everything, I think about the album that put Ariana Grande, like, I don't want to say on the map, but it definitely defined her as a star.
Yeah.
I mean, I just think about like what the era brought. You had Break Free. You had Problem. You had, oh my God, let me think.
One
you had Bang
time.
Bang. You had One Last Time. Love Me Harder.
Break
there
heart,
were so many like hits that it was really like, dang, this girl's a threat. She's a threat.
Definitely.
And she's stuck ever since. Like, it just, her discography to me is one to be envied.
Yeah, I mean,
no, like, she has a good discography.
I don't think Ari's had one miss.
I don't think so either.
Sweetener was controversial, but it won a Grammy. So, I mean,
no, but for real, I mean, I feel like with this revisit, one, we haven't revisited an album in a very long time. It's been a bunch of like newer albums, so to kind of, you know, backtrack.
Yeah.
I'm really excited. Yeah. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun, a lot of nostalgia.
That's our favorite thing, though. That's my favorite thing about the revisits. Because I feel like when you're listening to a new album, like you're focused, you're hearing everything for the first time.
Yeah.
But when you know everything, it's like strictly about having a good time.
Yeah.
So I agree with you.
I'm excited.
That's what I'm excited about.
Now, I will be honest, the only song I have never heard straight through, to my recollection, is My Everything. Is that bad?
Listen, if you're going to be Jada Weta, you have to be Jada Weta.
I'm
going to
be Jada.
If you're going to be an Ariana native, you have to be an Ariana native.
No,
and that is not being an Ariana native.
I know what I am.
Well, we don't.
Before we get started, we just wanted to shout out our Patreon. Over there, you can find a couple of full-length Ariana Grande reactions, including a couple of exclusives, you know, some that aren't on the channel.
Wait, what's exclusive?
What do you mean, what's exclusive?
What did we film that's exclusive? I still think that is her best intro.
Really? Over Raindrops?
I do.
Really?
Yeah.
Raindrops fell.
Okay. The reason
Are you sure? Really? That's I
maybe
don't know.
Maybe you have a point. The reason why I like this as an intro is because it feels so classic and vintage and like classic Ariana Grande, I should say. It's just a gorgeous intro, and I read somewhere that it was for the fans.
Yeah.
Which I think is another great way to kick off the album. Yeah.
We'll be shining every night. Nothing less. Like, it makes a lot of sense, and I guess for this, you know, her fans is really what carried over from, like, Victorious and really, you know, helped move her, you know, like,
definitely.
Musically. And to go from, it's hard to go from an actress to a singer and blow up as hard as she did, so, you know, definitely have to.
And do it successfully. But I don't know, it's like a twinkle in the back. Like, it just felt magical, and that's what I love about it. But, yeah, with Raindrops, you bring up a great point. But, My Everything, great way to start it. Let's go. Oh, I love two black queens. Can I just say that I still think this is one of her best pre-choruses?
Oh, yeah, of course.
This will get you hype every single time. Oh, yeah, of course.
I feel like I should turn it up.
I think you should turn it up.
Okay, yeah.
I can hear the growth, though.
And you know what's so crazy to find out this is Big Sean?
Yeah, yeah. Wild. Not wild. But you know, he was.
Ziggy is.
What you got? Small money betting, I'll be better off without you. Saying that you know, but I really, really doubt you. Understand my life is easy when I ain't around you. Biggie and you too biggie to be distressing. I'm finally on my list. Stepping either you wanted it, you just playing. I'm listening to you knowing I can't believe what you're saying. Like 99 times, but you won't be one. Like what?
She said,
she like killed what? That. Be honest, she killed that.
Times will be wiser.
That's not how she ended the song.
I know.
Like I said, I love when two black queens come together and just make a great music.
It's really wholesome to see that.
It is.
It really is.
UNITY, that spells unity.
UNITY.
Yeah. You ever notice that when a song gets really big, people start to hate?
Yeah.
Because y'all like to act like this ain't a hit. I understand it got mainstream. Maybe it was overplayed.
But there's a reason why.
And years later, I feel like it's easier to appreciate it.
It is.
This is a great song.
When you think about this, this was 2014?
Yeah.
That was such an era.
Yeah, it was.
It's so crazy. And then again, like, you know, with this one, I would definitely say Ariana was embracing her inner sexy, I think, a little bit more.
Even if it's just not sexy, like,
inner woman, just a little bit more.
Maturity,
and though. It was a time to be alive.
It was.
I'm gonna note that. And, like, Iggy was everywhere.
Yeah.
So it's just,
I don't know if this came off the back of Fancy or, like,
I think it
the
did.
Hype
I think
it.
Or, like, the hype of Fancy.
Yeah, this is about Ariana, but, like, Iggy, y'all don't give Iggy her
credit.
No,
you guys gotta give Iggy her credit. And this song is just, like, the video was cool. It's one of those songs that you hear and you just don't forget it.
Agreed. And it kicks the album off the best.
But the fact that there were a lot of great potential lead singles on this album.
Some of Ariana's, if not most of Ariana's most memorable tracks are on this
album.
And then you follow it up with this. Extravagant.
I just,
shit on it, fart on it, throw it up. I don't know what the fuck the guy has said.
Spit on it, vomit on it, throw a shit of bricks on it. I don't know.
Like,
let me say this. If One Last Time is not within your top five Ariana Grande songs of all time, that top five list is whack.
Throw it out.
Because One Last Time is one of Ariana's best songs.
I often debate with myself if it is my favorite.
Like,
it's that good.
Holy crap, this song is amazing.
It's that good. I'm gonna be honest with y'all though.
What?
That video made me mad.
Okay. Now, okay.
I don't know what we were doing.
I'm not saying that there more could have been done, but I'm also saying that more could have been done.
I'm not saying that the girls weren't doing their thing, but they were not doing their thing, and that's my problem.
And I'm really glad that we got what was like a little bit of a victorious reunion.
Yeah, that's nice.
That's great.
But I could have watched a rerun.
That's what I'm saying.
Sorry.
Nonetheless, aside from the video, because we do forget about the video.
Yeah.
The lyric video was really nice.
The purple smoke was nice.
It had a nice hue to it. You know what I'm saying? One Last Time, vocally, sonically, lyrically, yeah, just melodically. It's so, to me, this song feels timeless.
I agree with that. But at the same time, it does sound dated in the sense that her music has definitely
evolved,
matured, yes. Yes. And even strengthened.
Of course.
Like, you can see that this was at an earlier time in her career. But, like we said, there are a lot of tracks on this album
where,
that you will remember Ariana Grande for.
Yes, and I think
that's one of them.
Yeah, One Last Time is just...
There's a reason why. It's the next one up for a billion.
I'm not gonna lie. That song was pretty underrated for me. That one I used to skip a lot.
I'm taking your card.
And
today.
I know.
I'm surprised you knew the intro.
I am more of an Ariana Grande fan than you will ever be.
I'm not seeing it.
No, but you will.
I'd like to see it.
As much as I didn't play it, I still knew it and respected it for what it was. And this song, vocally, is extremely strong.
I agree with this.
I think it really pushes her vocals, especially that chorus.
I would say that's the strongest so far on the album, actually.
Oh, yeah, definitely the strongest on the album. Like,
yeah,
that push, I mean, we all know Ariana is a powerhouse.
For sure.
So I think these are one of those songs that show how she knows how to belt, but it's not screaming. There's a difference.
There's a difference.
Oof, is there a difference?
I feel like actually on this album I can hear Ariana either holding back or that she hadn't fully come into her own vocally yet. Maybe it's because of the songs that they are, like the more radio friendly and pushed toward mainstream, to where it's more about the melody.
Right.
Like listening to this and then hearing like Positions or Thank You Next or, you know, mm-hmm, even Dangerous Woman, the next album,
mm-hmm,
I can hear the difference, mm-hmm, in her vocal ability. Mm-hmm. And obviously that happens with time, but mm-hmm, I agree with you. Yes, Why Try is one of those tracks that really show off that ability. And
I agree with that.
This run so far, Break Free being next.
And then
Ariana, you've been saying that this entire album, and yet you still want him. Get harder, oh. This means I might hit a white boy.
ready?
Thought on your body I came alive. It was lethal.
Yeah. But then to follow with it was lethal. It was like,
it's a lethal. She got lethal gas?
I'm saying.
I'm sure you would wake up.
My God. Every time I think about Break Free, I think about that performance. That was a legendary, iconic performance.
That was amazing.
To me, a legendary song. I think this song was so good. Yeah.
Three.
Yeah. Break Free is such a, like you said, it was kind of controversial.
A little bit.
The video?
Even the video.
A little bit. Like,
for her brand.
It's so cool to see her growth, but like Jordan said, even to hear it in her voice. Like, she sounds so young, which is so, it's so cool at the same time. But to know that she was so young carrying such hits on her back, it's just crazy.
I know her back hurts. Yeah.
It still hurts.
Those are future back problems.
Yeah.
I feel like Break Free became such an anthem.
Yes.
You know, like, and the beat hits so hard. Yeah. Zed was on that one.
Yeah.
Like, what? Yeah. Like, we are six songs deep.
And there's not one miss. It being yet another non-miss.
Now, I'll be honest.
What?
I paid this one dust.
And that lets me know that you're not an Ariana Grande fan. Checkmate. Gotcha. Yeah. Yeah.
That is a good song.
That fucking piano.
And soon do we forget how we felt. Dealing with emotions. They never met. Maybe I'm a sinner and not a saint. Gotta stop pretending what we ain't. Why we pointing fingers anyway? Wake up, make up, so where's the time? Can we please make up our minds and stop acting like we're flying?
Do you think how that kind of reflects the album? Make up, break up. That's literally all we've done on the album.
Yeah, that's kind of.
And honestly, I'm not even trying to read too deep into the album, but I just.
No, I think it's like, good. That's a good reflection. A good sum up, yeah.
Right in the middle too.
Yeah.
I'll be saving my love for you, 'cause you're the best mistake I've ever made. But we hold on.
I guess time's wasting, tick-tocking, lip-locking. How can we keep the feelings fresh? How do we zip-lock it? I know love can be a beach with no shore. I done counted 10, lost my temper and went back to 4. I had a dream, we branched out, started a family tree. And I feel like that every
branched out and started a family tree. No, Big Sean is so underrated.
Now you, I can hit.
You ask why I love your mom so much, 'cause she's a older you. Ain't no number twos, we both ones of ones, and we the oddest.
I don't know what
it's
okay.
A couple of humans except you a goddess.
That's why I'm not
lying to you when I.
If I'm not the one, then I'm the best mistake you ever had.
Wake up, tell to waste it, and stop acting like we're lying.
I think I paid that one dust.
I think, okay, and I don't know if I'm gonna get a lot of flack for this. I think that's better than Right There.
Hmm.
Am I wrong? Am I right? Am I right?
Oh, it's because you listen
right there.
Right
Like I'm saying,
whoa there, partner.
Regardless.
You just can't confuse maturity with better.
No, that's what I'm trying not to do. But no, I love Best Mistake. I think that pre-chorus is actually one of the best on the album. Very, very good pre-chorus. And I think kind of like what you said, it kind of sums up a lot of the topics on the album in one song. You guys have to stop discrediting Sean.
I always say this, like, Sean is...
That verse is so hard.
One of the best rappers.
How do we keep the feelings fresh? How do we ziplock it? I know it can be seen as corny.
But yeah, but
it's a lot. But it's kind of clever, yo. Like, it's kind of clever. I don't know. I like his verse.
It's the way he structured it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think... And then, you know, it's so funny because they were fucking...
Ariana said, you wanna fuck me?
And they, you know, they were together during this time. And I feel like a lot of people kind of forget that. That they were an item. This song, it's good. I wish they pushed this a little bit more.
They don't have a video?
No.
Oh.
They have a performance.
Oh, okay. You know, I said I take a lot with me, but this is when I leave back, and I'm gonna tell you why.
Yeah, I agree.
I feel like this song was something new, something fresh, something good for the summertime when it came out.
Yes.
But it sounds a lot like an underdeveloped version of what you'd hear on Dangerous Woman. I think that this was her experimenting with that sound that she'd later explore and nail.
Yeah.
And Into You, Side to Side, Every Day, things like that.
Yeah.
I guess dipping into that hip-hop bag a little bit.
Okay.
I
can agree with you saying this is a little bit underdeveloped. This has always been my least favorite on the album. And so...
I think same.
Like, it puts a little smile on my face, but again, I think it does feel a little bit amateur, a little bit immature, maybe. When you compare it to the rest of the album, that is, this is just one that it's not memorable. I think Kashmir did a great job producing it.
Yeah, the beat's warm.
It's lukewarm to me, you know? I was about to say, okay. This song is about her gay ex.
I forgot that it literally
like summarized it right there.
So how did I never catch so that?
Diana Ross.
I'm coming out.
Yes.
I was gonna make that point.
She's a messy one.
She's a messy one.
That's very clever.
That is creative as fuck, but I didn't know that.
I guess Ariana in that situation is like, okay, well, at least it wasn't me. I'm truly not your type. Like, it wasn't anything that I did.
Yeah,
You're right, boys.
You can't help it, but you like boys.
You know what I mean? Hey,
that he was gay?
I don't know. I just can't break your heart. Oh no, I was blind running around so I made my baby love me.
And they're like, oh no, no. And he was.
over. I just wanna break your heart right back. Right back. Won't you call me your river?
You got a man, but your man ain't loyal. Don't understand how to spell it out for you. Yes, I'm a G from the A, and they ask why. Sorry, had to tell you I'm a nice guy.
I'm trying to see how he did that. Yes, I'm a G from the A. G-I-Gay? Because now you got me looking at this song different. Like, click it. Let me see if I'm right. Why? And that's what I'm saying. And they ask why. So G-A-Y. Gay.
G-A-M-B-I-N-O-I. I know they hate, but I don't know why. I know the way he did you was whack, but I know how you can get through like that.
You know what I mean?
That is wild.
Because when I first heard the song, obviously back in 2014, it never clicked. I never paid attention to the lyrics.
Not enough, yeah.
So then when we were getting ready to revisit the album, I was like, let me take a look at the album. I looked at it and I was like, hold on a second.
Yeah, like...
I think this is what... And then I paid attention to the sample. And I was like, wait a minute. Very clever.
Yeah, it's actually...
Very clever.
Pretty...
And it's a humorous song. It's a funny song.
It's a genius record, low-key.
It really is. I really like Childish as a feature. Yeah. I think he's also someone that is criminally underrated. But for this one, it's definitely the tick up that was needed on the album coming after Be My Baby.
Yeah.
So again, like I said, the album dipped for a second and then it comes right back.
Pretty much,
Break Your Heart Right Back is, it's so clever. It definitely has that old school feel. I don't know. This is one that I like singing along to. It's a really cool song.
Agreed. Anytime someone flips that sample,
yeah,
it's always great. So this one has always been one of my favorite tracks. It's always been in my top four probably. But now discovering this new layer to it, I'm like,
I like how the song,
it draws from like personal experience. This is a really nicely constructed track. And then we go on to Love Me Harder. And
tell me something I need to know. Then take my breath and never let it go. I'll take the pleasure, take it with the pain. And if in the moment I bite my lip, give me a reason to believe it. Cause if you want to keep it, you're
I think that song I heard more than any other. I feel like I heard that one more than I heard Problem.
I agree.
I feel like I heard that one more than I heard Break Free. Like, that song.
That just, song was everywhere.
It's probably because, it was a hit on the radio, but people genuinely love that song. No, so because when you're with friends, when you're at parties, you're going to hear that song.
It's because, listen, when The Weeknd and Ariana Grande collaborate, you think we have Love Me Harder, we have Off the Table, we have Save Your Tears Remix.
Yeah.
They really put their foot in whatever they collaborate with.
Yeah.
And I think it's because their voices complement each other so well.
Which one's your favorite?
Oh, that's hard. Even when it comes to Save Your Tears Remix, like, that is hard.
I'm going with this one.
I think it might still be this one.
This was just
a moment. Off the Table is a close second.
Close. But I was listening and I was picking on parallels between Why Try and Love Me Harder. Okay. And I never noticed that before.
Okay.
But they kind of both speak to the concept of the album. You know, it being called My Everything, it feels like we're dealing with the same person throughout the whole thing.
Yes.
So you're dealing with everything you feel when someone is your everything, is your world.
Yeah.
And
yeah, for sure.
You know, obviously that song was about fucking, but
of course, and I think it was such a hit also because it was done so tastefully.
Yeah,
that even saying "Can you feel the pressure in your hips?" and that is such those words are so enticing and
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like it was just done so tastefully,
and that's why I can see that's what's amazing about Ariana's career. You can see the progression. It was My Everything. You know, you hear the way she was kind of creeping up on it.
Yeah,
and then Dangerous Woman.
And then it was like
side to side.
I'm owning this. Yeah.
Cried in the car to that one.
It's so beautiful.
I definitely looked out the window while it was raining.
It's so beautiful. And cried. It's so beautiful.
It's one of her best ballads to this day.
Yeah, to this day.
To this day.
To this day! Oh, it's so pretty. It's so simply...
The instrumental. Like,
beautiful.
Yeah. It creates this experience for you where your heart, you can just feel it like...
It's
gushing up. Like, it's just
like it's...
It's expanding.
Feel it. Yeah.
You feel like it. The Grinch. Damn, just a little piece of your heart. Like, I gotta rub my titty.
To say, really, a little love is better than none.
Oh, you just feel that for something.
Yeah. Whew. I always feel like that is one of Ariana's most criminally underrated songs.
Yes, yes.
And then they go to Hands On Me.
Keep your hands on me, don't take
it. Ooh, speaking of rubber titties. Okay, I don't remember that lyric.
What, the I might be a little thing, but I like that long?
Yeah, I don't know why I don't remember that lyric. She was definitely taking it there.
Keep your hands on me.
ham on it, ham on it.
Ah, cause it's still wet. You know what's funny? A lot of people always used to kind of like shit on that song. I've always liked it. He's one that shits on it.
I don't shit on it. I take like a fart on it just because like...
Fart on my body, I came alive.
Yeah. So, literally. But, my thing is that it's kind of the same thing with Be My Baby. Like, it was her really? Taking a whack at something that she was going to do later on and do better.
Better at.
But I will say, listening to this now... It is better than I remember. It's just one of those songs that is going to feel dated.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. It just doesn't have that same timeless feel that the rest of the album does.
No, I feel like, yeah, this one was definitely just done for fun. But like you said, coming up with like the other albums, it was
right. done a lot like, better. I definitely feel like if she knew what she was going to do later on and how she was going to do it,
yeah,
those two songs probably would have been left off. But this is what happens. You experiment in the era that you're in. And then if you want to repeat something,
you kind of go back.
You do so. And this was definitely her album full of hits, radio hits at that. So this was her space to experiment with everything.
Yeah.
And kind of dip her toe into everything. Everything, so, yeah. ASAP killed it, though. I will say that.
It's your birthday.
Birthday with me.
I cried enough tears to see my own reflection in.
That song, let me be clear, it's been a very long time and I love it. That is a great title track.
I was gonna say, I love when albums put the title track at the end
to definitely sum it up.
Yeah, to definitely cap it. So I've always thought that was a really cool thing.
Everything till we were nothing.
Right, and that maybe I didn't appreciate... explains the tumultuous relationship throughout the entire thing.
Yes,
but also the little... throughout it reminds me of the intro.
The intro.
It feels like a mirror.
Yes.
Like we started or we ended the way we started. And I like that as well. So My Everything is obviously a gorgeous song. I think that this is another underrated one, but one that's very tailored to this album.
Yes.
If that makes sense.
Like I couldn't just see her slapping this on any like tour set list.
Right. Very specific. Right. And maybe she has, but
to the album.
It's to the album, yeah. And maybe that tour. Great song, great vocals, definitely.
It's a good way to end the album.
I think showcases vocally what's great about this album all in one song. Yeah. Stacked vocals, harmonies, very light, airy.
Yeah.
Which is what she showcased most on this album. So
yes, the airy vocals.
Yeah.
Yes, I have to agree with that.
Yeah, solid.
So that is My Everything, yet another Ariana album that we have revisited. And again, when you go back.
Yeah.
And listen to somebody's previous work, it's just crazy to see how much they've grown. And like we said with My Everything, you just see the bits and pieces that she carried over into her, you know, projects that have been released after.
Yeah.
It's so crazy to see that this was like the experimental ground for those kinds of songs. But even though they were experiments, they were still done to perfection. They were still done so well.
They paid off.
I mean, my everything is, like Jordan said, the album with all of Ariana's hits, her
a lot of her staple hits.
Yeah, a lot of her staple
albums in her discography.
Album. Yeah.
Ditto to everything, you know, that you said. I feel like this album definitely, I always have a hard time ranking Ariana's albums, and I'm gonna be real. We're thinking about doing a video on that.
Once we finish, we only have one more album that's yours truly, and then after that, we want to rank all the albums and see specifically what about each album gives it its ranking. So it's just, again, like, when you look at this, I see someone who took a chance on something new.
Yeah.
And really blossom from it. I mean, like I keep saying, I'm a huge Ariana Grande fan. I didn't realize how much of an Ariana Grande fan I was until I looked at my playlist and realized that it consists of a lot of Ariana Grande, but that is just because she is an amazing singer-songwriter. She really takes, as fast as she shits out albums, she really does take her time.
She does. And I'll say also, like, with this album, it has a lot to do with having the right people around you as well. The right producers.
Yes.
You know, the right A&R, the right executives.
Yeah.
To really make a project that is going to last and be a hit. So it's not many people can say that their albums are full
of
five or more hits. You know what I mean? And that says a lot. So shout out to Ariana.
But this is one of those albums where my everything, when you think about it, you just think of all those timeless hits. You think of the era that it was. You think of
the moments that came with it.
And it's such a nice feeling. I love to say that we lived through that. And we were in the centerfold of that. Like, as it was happening, we were, dare I say, like, old enough to comprehend just how, like, monumental everything really was.
Absolutely.
So it's really cool.
Listening to this, I feel like Ariana's career is definitely split up into two parts.
Oh, hell yeah.
I feel like it goes yours truly, my everything, Dangerous Woman, Sweetener,
Thank You Next, Positions.
Yeah. It's just like that, two different Ariana's.
It really is. It really is.
And so with AG7, I don't know.
Yeah, AG7.
What it's gonna be.
I don't know.
On her seventh
album. That's crazy.
Yeah, she's taking a break.
Yeah. As always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about this amazing album. Let us know your top three down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications. That way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.